Fitness Daily, and today we have Chelsea Bain.
Yay!
Yay, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm great, and I love this. What's going on today?
Thank you!
You look
beautiful. Lots of colors. Thank you.
I love it. It's working. You are so pulled together.
Trying to bring the sunshine.
You are a burst of sunshine today.
Thank you.
So, we're so excited to have you here and to talk about all your good stuff. And, of course, before, you know, we talk to you, we do a little stalking of your...
Oh, yeah.
The internet and social media, and we learned so many fun things. Oh, it's not scary at all. You have an amazing Instagram.
Thank you. Oh, thank you. That means so much to hear. I work really hard.
Do you work really hard?
I do.
Do you do your own Instagram?
I do my own Instagram, and it actually takes
so
a lot of planning. So I spend a crazy amount of time planning my social media, which seems insane, but these days I feel like you have to. There's competition.
Hard. 16-year-old daughter, and she tells me it's hard. I don't do mine.
Yeah, it's stressful.
Yeah.
I have to take a step. I go rock climbing after I plan social media, just to
You do really? A lot of cool things.
Thank you.
Yeah, and
you
have some great quotes on there that I'll tell you, we'll talk about later.
Hi.
But no, really cool, great stuff. It's beautiful.
Thank you.
So I learned all kinds of great things. But first of all, let's talk about real quick, we'll come back to it later, but before we even get started, the new music.
Yeah.
Great, great, great. Just in time.
Just in time.
Just in time is wonderful. And I like my favorite song. This might be Why Don't You?
Yay! I'm not gonna lie, that's my favorite.
It's so good. I love it. It's really good.
My hair and makeup artist had to listen to me just like she was trying to curl my hair and stuff, and I'm like sitting there playing it, and I think she's like, are you tired of the song yet? And she's like, no, not yet, actually.
Yeah, no, it's gonna be a while before I'm tired of that song.
Yay! Yeah, oh, I love that. Thank you.
Yeah, it's great. So there's a lot of good stuff on there, but that's, I just had to put that in out there.
That's okay. The groove, man. Yeah. Me and Rachel Farley wrote that with Ross Lipsey, and I was like, we need to write with Ross Lipsey again, because he brought that like little sweet groove to it, and I was like, oh, I just want to move my shoulders like this for the whole time, all day.
Yeah, it's good. So you bring up Rachel, who I know that you are a serious songwriter.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and Rachel is a serious songwriter.
Yes.
How did the two of you come together?
Songwriting.
How did you meet? How did it all?
I was working with Michael Knox, producer and publisher here in town, and he was going to be producing a project of mine, and Rachel was writing at the company he was publishing at the time, and he was like, here's some songs from this super young girl and all this stuff, and I listened to so many songs out of her catalog, and I was like, I want to sing all of them. And I ended up cutting two of her songs, but also writing at the company for, you know, a few weeks, just seeing what I came up with and stuff too. And I ran into Rachel in the hall, and she was wearing a Goodwill, I think it was Sylvester, on overalls that day. So I'm calling Rachel out for that right now. And I immediately fell in love with her because I was like, that's hilarious. We'd have fun together. And because when I'm at home, I don't look like this. I'm like real mismatched socks, and just, it's tragic. And probably an oversized t-shirt with, you know, like some food on my face or something. And we ran into each other in the hall, and we're just talking, and we realized we both have dogs. Well, she has plural, I have one, Rhodey, my heart and soul. And we're like, we need to get our dogs together. That's how we met and ended up hanging out, because we decided we need to get our dogs together for a play date, which initially our dogs didn't actually like each other. So that was, they like each other now. And we ended up getting together and having a 3-hour coffee and realizing that we had to be friends because we A, had so much in common, and B, kind of spilled our guts and told a lot of secrets, and you know, we had, you know, be friends or kill each other, you know, one of the two.
Friends is better.
But we didn't write together until a year after we'd been friends.
Wow.
Yeah. I think secretly, we didn't talk about this till after the fact, but secretly we were both like, but if we do that, is that gonna like mess with our friendship? We didn't want to mess that up because we both finally found people that like, oh man, I like this person and they're not annoying. And so yeah, a year later, I came to her and I was like, I have a lot going on in my life and it sucks and I need somebody I really trust to write these songs with me and help me to get this out. And then it turned out that she's like almost the only person I trust for a lot of my stuff these days, because I'm very open when I write. And almost too open, I think. Because sometimes I listen to my songs and I'm like, oh, that's out there now. People know about that. My mom heard that lyric. Cool. But yeah, she's made writing, you know, writing music's already fun and I love it, but she made it tremendously, you know, tenfold for me.
Yeah. And you guys work together on almost every song, yeah?
Yeah, we're a little psychotic. if I have a writing session or she has a writing session, usually we call each other and say, hey, you're coming, right? And she plays in my band, and she actually works with me on the business end too, and kind of helps me. She's a type A person, so I'm like, can you just make sure I don't forget something, pretty please? And so we basically do everything together, and I think a lot of people on my team might say that it gets a little scary at times because we really are very synced. And so it can be really obnoxious. You could be sitting at a table with us and be like, all right, are they having their own dinner right now? Or what's going on? This is awkward.
It's working.
It's a really crazy best friend thing. Yeah.
It's great, and you guys are having a good time.
We're having a blast.
That's
like, I'm working with my best friend in all of this. And radio touring and you know, just playing shows and stuff. And I'm like, I never dreamt that I'd have one of my best friends with me through that. It's the coolest.
That's great.
Thank you.
It's great. It's awesome. It's awesome. So, are you going to be touring for this new music?
Yes, that is the main goal this year, is to be on the road as much as physically possible and doing radio, playing shows everywhere and anywhere we can.
Right.
I mean, this is a project that I'm most proud of, and it is closest to me than any other project I've ever done. Mm-hmm. So it's really important that I get it played for as many years as possible. Just, you know, and I love playing shows and going out and talking to fans and seeing, because I mean, none of us have been through anything unique. We've all been through the same things in some form. And I love running into a fan that's like, oh my gosh, that really hit me, and I felt that same thing, I've been through that same thing. And so that's what I'm excited to see, is if my fans have been through all the craziness that I did.
They have. And this will definitely have an impact on them, and that'll feel good.
I hope so.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, I think so. So where can everybody find you? Will the tour be on there on your website? Is that the best place for them to
every show, everything will be on my Instagram, which is Chelsea Bain, Twitter, my Facebook fan page, and on my website.
Okay.
So it'll just be blasted everywhere.
And your website is just your name, Chelsea Bain.
ChelseaBainMusic.
ChelseaBainMusic.com.
Yes.
Okay. And then I assume that all your socials are easy to find.
Oh, yeah. I'm there.
Oh, yeah.
I'm like, hi! Be my friend.
What else do we know? What else do we need to know?
Oh, my gosh. Well, we have a show coming up in Georgia, so that's exciting.
Yeah.
Our first show this year, and I'm really looking forward to that. And a co-writer of ours from Georgia, Mike Deagle, love him dearly, him and Rachel are actually going to be opening for me.
Okay.
They're
going to
do a little writer's
cool.
round, and then
awesome.
My band and I are going to play it. So it'll really be the first time I've gotten to play this new music.
Oh, that's awesome.
For fans.
When is that?
That is March 9th.
Oh, nice.
Oh, I remembered it. Yeah.
That's good. And then just from there, you're just going to keep going.
We're gonna keep going.
Nice.
You know, working with my booking agency and just trying to get as many shows as possible. And you know, to everybody here, if you live somewhere and you want me to come play, like, just let me know. I mean, I'm so excited about this that more is more.
Right. That's awesome. Now you're gonna be like, you know, flooded. You keep telling your fans that you'll be flooded.
I want to be flooded.
That's awesome.
I want to be flooded.
That's
I want to have no time to think about anything else and just be immersed in all of this and really get to live this music out.
That's awesome.
Thank you.
Well, I'm so glad to meet you.
I'm so glad to meet you too.
This is great. I can't wait to see you in one of those cities. Maybe I'll, you know, send you a message to come to my city and
please do.
Come out, and so I can't wait to see you.
Thank you.
Tour this music. It's great.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me.
Excellent. Excellent. It's very well done. Thank you.
Thank you.